Hi, I'm Danny and welcome to another Tech Fix tutorial. Thank you for joining me. This video is going to look at Wakelet, which is a fantastic resource for curating your own web links and resources and videos and sharing them with students or creating links for your own personal use. Let's take a look. So if you've not seen Wakelet before, the first thing to do is to go to www.wakelet.com and click on the sign up button. Or down here, sign up is free. You can set up a Google account, a Microsoft account or Facebook, or you can sign up with your own email and password. So go and do that. So when you've set up your account, you'll see a page like this. I've already set up one collection already, so I'll just show you very quickly what that looks like. So if I click on here, you've got the title, a quick graphic, and then all the resources running down the page. So these are mainly web links. Some of these are links to YouTube videos. Some of these are links to particular guides I've found setting up online classrooms, online resources. If I want to add more things to it, I just click on Edit Collection and I can add things to it like that. So I'll bail out of there and start a brand new collection. So if I click on Create a New Collection, the first thing you can do is enter a title, so I'll enter a title in there. You can enter a description, in the box there. You can choose a cover image if you want, you can upload an image of your own, or you can choose from a library, and there's a whole library of ready-made images that you can have that are provided by Wakelet. So let's just choose one at random. There we go. And you can choose whether to have the image as a full cover or as a half cover, so just slightly smaller. There we go. And then there's a little green plus just down the bottom of the screen here. Let's just move that down slightly. So if I click on that green plus, I then get a choice of things to put in there. So if I want to add in a URL, or I want to add some text or a YouTube video, I just choose from there. So let's do a URL. So I've got a blog over here I'm going to use, so I'm just going to copy the URL, which you can't see, that's just off the screen there. I'm going to go back to here, click on the plus, click on paste URL, and in that box I'm just going to paste that in there, and it'll play around for a little while, and then it'll put in my web link just there. If I want to add something else, I want to add a YouTube video, I can click on the plus, I can go to YouTube, and from there I can search directly. So I could find another guide to Wakelet and see what's in there. It'll find other people's tutorials which are there, or I could go to YouTube, and again if I click on share and I grab that link, I'll just copy that link, I can then go back to Wakelet, click on the plus, paste URL, and paste the YouTube URL straight into there, and what it will then do is put the YouTube video straight into my page. If I want to add any other kind of resource, I just click on that plus there, and there's loads of other things I can put in. If I've got files on Google Drive, I can add Google Drive or OneDrive, or even tweets as well. I can change the layout, so I can have it as a media view, or I can have a much more compact view which shrinks it down like that. Or even go to grid view, which then makes them much smaller, which is what you saw in the previous one that I'd set up. If I then want to share this with my students, up in the top corner, just up here, it's set to private. If I change that, I can set it to be public, which means that anybody can find it through Wakelet itself, they can search for it. But also, the best way probably is to do it as unlisted. So if I click it as unlisted, that means that it's not appearing in a public area within Wakelet. But if I give that link to anybody, I can share it with them and they can find it. So if I want to share it with somebody, I click on share, and there's various ways I can do it. I can take that link and I can copy it, or I can click on there and I can get a QR code. I can make the QR code bigger by clicking on the double arrow there. I can then screen grab that, or just have that presented on the screen so the students can scan that with their phones and go straight there. I could export my Wakelet as a PDF file, or I could embed it elsewhere if I wanted to. You've also got things like sharing it to Twitter and to Facebook and to other places like Teams as well, or Google Classroom. That's basically it. Wakelet is completely free. It's a fantastic resource for collecting, even if you have resources that you're just sharing for yourselves and collecting things for yourself as a way of curating your own bookmarks, like things like Digo or Delicious used to do back in the day. You can also invite other people. If I click up on the invite button here, I can invite other people to contribute to the same page. So you could set up a class Wakelet and have students all putting their own resources on, so they can actually set up a shared Wakelet for themselves, which would have resources they're all finding, and they can all put things on there to help each other. So that's Wakelet. I hope you found that useful. It's a really cool resource for creating your own set of links. Do take a look at it, check it out, and see what you think. Hope you found this video useful. If you liked it, please remember to subscribe and like this video. Any questions, add them in the comments below, and I'll answer them as quickly as I can. Hope to see you again next time. Thanks very much. Bye-bye.